It's simpler than you think, unless you already think it's simple. In which case, I like the way you think. We're going to build a full tech stack made entirely of no-code tools. The goal, to allow a non-tech founder to build an app that reaches the limits of what no-code app development offers. If you use this tech stack, whatever you can't do will probably need a developer, or you just didn't read the instructions properly. Just for context, my name is Adrian, and I've been running an app development agency for the past 6 years. I'd like to think I know my way around tech stack. So this is another day at work for me. The condition this time is that I can only pick no-code friendly options, and my priority is function, not simplicity or cost saving. No noobs or cheapskates allowed. Just kidding. All these tools have free trials. The functions we want to cover are front-end development, back-end development, user authentication, and automation and third-party integrations. I don't know when you're watching, but just in case this video ages like milk, as of filming this, these are damn good pieces of software. Are they the only great options? No, there's always another, and that's the problem. There's always another. If you're the type that goes from video to video looking for the perfect tool, I've got a recommendation. Stop looking for recommendations. If you're like most non-tech founders getting into no-code, I'm 99% sure this tech is good enough for you. Let's look at the first component, front-end development. The TLDR version is Bubble for web apps, DraftBit for mobile apps. As a rule, most front-end app builders give you a drag-and-drop interface with blocks of ready-made elements that you can arrange on a screen. You have design elements that determine how your app looks. You have logic elements that determine how users and designs interact, aka the user experience. Since we're building a function-focused tech stack, we want a drag-and-drop builder that offers the most variety of functions, especially with the logic. For that reason, I recommend Bubble for web-based applications and DraftBit for anything mobile. Their builders let you put together very technical conditions and dynamic expressions. It means you have a lot of freedom to create apps that respond differently to users based on their input. If you can imagine it, Bubble and DraftBit can probably help you realize that. That can't be said for every drag and drop builders out there. DraftBit is a dedicated front-end builder, but for simple apps, Bubble can actually also be your backend. You can use Bubble, but... Bubble, but... But for this tech stack, we'll want to go with a dedicated backend provider. That brings us to the second component, backend development. For the only no-code backend you ever need, I'll slot in backendless. Your backend is where all the data gets stored and retrieved. These functions alone would mean a very simple backend, and if we look at Bubble's database manual, that's pretty much what it lets developers do. It also offers suggestions for how to structure your database based on app type, and there's quite a few different options. It's serviceable, but Bubble doesn't come close to the types of features that backendless offers. Let's take a look. Those API calls cover a lot of different functions, way more than Bubble. I'm not hating at all. I'm not trying to burst your bubble. Bubble is not marketed as an all-in-one solution. It sells itself as a premier front-end builder that just happens to have a backend. Thankfully, Bubble and DraftBit knows this and make it easy for you to connect a front-end on their platform with a backendless database using API call. They both have step-by-step guides for non-tech folks to easily integrate backendless. But what about insert whatever backend tool you have heard of? Sure, they'll probably work. There are a few established tier one backend providers, but you just need one. Is backendless good enough? I always say check a developer's portfolio before hiring them. Let's look at backendless portfolio. Look at this. Backendless supports a full-fledged banking app. You're talking about strict security requirements, hundreds if not thousands of simultaneous users, and integration with payment gateways and God knows what else. Backendless can handle all that in addition to all the other apps it supports. If you want to use another backend provider like Xano or 8base, check out their portfolios and see what they're capable of. But for now, backendless it is. Front and backend done. let's make it easy on our users with the third-party component, user authentication. Say hello to Auth0 and FREEBIES, two of the most comprehensive authentication and authorization platforms on the market. They are staples even in code-based tech stacks. Developers use them all the time. Customizing login protocols and security settings is difficult even for a developer who doesn't specialize in that area. Say you want to authenticate via SMS or a one-time password, or you have multiple apps and sites and you want a single login per user across all of them. Good luck trying to do that yourself. The simplest, fastest way to implement complex login processes like that is through a tool like Auth0 or FREEBIES. If your app deals with sensitive data, you'll want to meet compliance requirements. I can't see how a non-tech founder is going to do that, so save yourself the headache, let Auth0 do it for you. You just focus on the processes you want to implement. They've got a list of use cases, and if we take a look at some of them, depending on the kind of app you want to build, those are really practical security measures. Here's where we run into a small problem. Bubble can easily connect to Auth0 and FREEBIES. But what about DraftBit? Not really, not yet anyway. Someone had that exact same question, and look at the DraftBit team's response. Those cheeky monkeys. So, we're in a bit of a pickle. Say I want this tech stack to use DraftBit and I want to include either FREEBIES or Auth0 as my authentication service. However, they don't have pre-built APIs for me to easily connect them. Normally, I would just and write a custom API, but what if I can't code? A perfect segue into our final tech stack component, automation and integration. Zapier is the software as a service version of that guy who knows everyone and is always open to introducing you to new business connections. For a price, Zapier acts as a middleman to transfer data between apps, kind of like a server. The beauty of Zapier is that it can be easily integrated into over 5,000 apps that cover any use case you can think of. And whatever your Zapier account is connected to, they're all connected to each other. You can now customize the flow of data between these apps, whether it's done manually, say when a user makes a request, or automatically based on whatever conditions you set. Then again, who needs to integrate with 5,000 apps? There are alternatives to Zapier. You might look at something like Integrately or Make. They've only got 1,000 integrations, but they're cheaper. You have more leeway with your choice. The point is to include some kind of integration tool in your tech stack. So the moment you need a new feature, just outsource it. So Bubble or DraftBit as your front end, Backendless as your back end, Auth0 or FREEBIES for user authentication, Zapier or Zapier-like tool for third-party integration and data automation. That is a hell of a tech stack, and if you take the time to learn to use the platforms, you can build very complex app. So the question is, do you actually need to build a complex app? You may not need a full-blown no-code tech stack. Take a look at these two pictures. The picture on the left is a goddamn wrench museum. They're all specialized, meaning you need to find more and more wrenches as you encounter different sizes. The adjustable wrench on the right may not do as perfect a job in each situation, but by itself, it lets you do a good enough job across multiple use cases. Your tech stack should only be as complicated as your app demands. There's levels to tech stack based on complexity. If your project is going to be really simple, you may only need that all-in-one app builder like Bubble for web or Adalo for mobile, since DraftBit doesn't have a built-in backend. If your project needs advanced backend logic, then you add on a dedicated backend like Backendless or any suitable alternative. If you want custom user authentication and custom whatever else that you can't build yourself, then you add on Zapier or any suitable alternatives. If you don't need it, don't use it. You always want to consolidate into fewer tools instead of spreading across more. So how do you know what you'll need? At the very least, this means doing some thorough requirements gathering for your MVP, so you know beforehand what you need to do at least to get to a prototype you can show your users. And with that, I'd like to invite you to attend an Upstack Studio product roadmapping workshop in the form of a YouTube video. When we get a new client, we spend a day planning their MVP. We make sure we understand our target users and their pain points and what our solution needs to offer initially, and nothing more than that. I still haven't found a smooth way to end my videos, but that's the end of this video. I have a request. For those who do have experience with no-code tools, rate my no-code tech stack. What would you give it out of 10? Are there alternatives that you would use, and are there any components I left out? Please subscribe and like this video, and I'll see you in the product roadmapping workshop.